could start by saying that I never expected to be in this position, to do documentaries with people, to be seen as the leading spokesperson for breatharianism in the world. Today, encyclopedias give me that name now, spiritual encyclopedias. You only have to go onto the internet to see all the references. A lot of negative things from people who don't understand, and a lot of positive from people who do understand. One thing, if I had known what would have been in store for me in the notoriety, in the public humiliation sometimes, in the negativity and the anger, in everything that's occurred for me personally, I would have never have done it. I would have never become public. I would have never have said anything. I just would have done what I did and enjoyed a quiet life. But I think sometimes it is in our blueprint, our destiny, to play certain roles in the evolution of humanity. And so I've grown as the challenges have grown, but personally it's been a difficult journey, you know. It's not like a human being, a Western human being, can come out and say, oh, guess what, there's this force of energy inside of you that is so powerful, it's all-knowing, it's all-loving, it's exquisite, it's sublime, it's extreme, you can feel it when you meditate on it, it loves you, it guides you, it heals you, and, by the way, it can give you all your nourishment, your vitamins, your minerals, everything you need to create a strong, healthy system. And when you let go of physical food and allow it to feed you, you get stronger, you get healthier, you get more creative, you get you need to sleep less, your life becomes magical. I mean, most people just think that's all crazy. And I guess 20 years ago, I didn't either understand all the capabilities and all the gifts that come to a human being when we really allow that divine love to flow through our being to the degree that it not just gives us life, but it can reveal its gifts. You know, and this path for me, it's never been about eating or not eating. It's been about really opening up and allowing the divinity inside, whatever we call it, a chance to reveal all its gifts and all its glory. And so the difficulty over the years has been that the first general public reaction when I started to share this on the global stage was that it was huge disbelief and a huge challenge, and also beyond people's mental comprehension, and brought back into this idea of eating or not eating, which is completely not what it's about. It's about really exploring human potential. You know, everything a doctor or a scientist says about a human system regarding nutrition is absolutely true when the brainwave patterns are anchored in what I call the beta frequency. But as soon as you start to engage in a spiritual lifestyle of meditation, of prayer, of service, of being in company of truth, of silence, of nature, of listening to devotional music, these sorts of things change the way the brain operates, changes the brainwave patterns from alpha to theta, and start to reveal amazing hidden capabilities within the human system, things that many people are still uneducated into understanding a human being can possibly do and manifest. So, you know, it's interesting to go against the conventional status quo and make statements that a human being can be a more tuned instrument if we stop watching so much television and refine our diet and eliminate our toxic thinking and toxic feeling patterns and maybe engage in things like yoga, meditation, other things, the whole physiology and operation of the system changes. And you can get very healthy and very happy and experience all sorts of things.